Good evening, friends. Hello, everybody watching around the world. It is the final day of the Let's Do It World Conference, and what an incredible couple of days it has been, with speakers from every continent discussing so many hot topics and issues about environmentalism, about the World Cleanup Day, and about how we can be a stronger network together. Of course, the network would be nothing without the individual strength of everybody involved, such wonderful people. And over the next hour, the Let's Do It team are going to celebrate you, all the people who volunteer, who give of your time, who put your heart and soul into making this such a strong and powerful network. So this is the Let's Do It World Awards. Big round of applause, everyone. Even though I can't hear you applauding, I can see you on the monitor there. And glad to see you all dressed up for the day. As you can see, I'm here with all these swanky awards behind me, the lights, the glittery. This is a big night, one of the biggest nights of the year. And hello to all of our friends as well who are watching on Facebook and YouTube, streaming all over the world as well. So we've got some great awards to give out tonight. Heidi will be going through the categories, myself and Heidi, she'll be giving them out, and we'll be doing some short interviews with some of the recipients. So I'm really looking forward to that. It's going to be fantastic, and we can take some questions maybe towards the end. And it's just going to be a lot of fun to celebrate and a way for us to have fun together after what has been an amazing conference. And then towards the end, Heidi will extinguish the candle, which was lit at the beginning of the sermon, the conference on Thursday. But one thing before we start, my friends, because if you have watched, you know, the Oscars or big awards ceremonies before, you'll know that they always like to make a really big and powerful opening where they pull out all the stops, they bring out the bands, the dancing, everything. So we wanted this to be no different. And when we had the after party just the other night, we got people to do their party pieces, and some people sang, some people danced, we even had rapping. But some people were giving out to me and saying that I didn't have a party piece. I didn't do anything. So earlier on today, you won't believe this, but we had a huge production where I performed a dance, especially for this opening ceremony. Now, this is 100% real. Are you ready to see this, my friends? Yes, thumbs up. Great. Holger, when you're ready, cue the amazing video to open the ceremony. How about that? There you go. Can I get a little round of applause for that? That was me. Did you like those moves? A smooth, beautiful move. Award ceremony today. Thank you. Thank you to show your appreciation. Thank you, my friends. Okay, enough of me messing and wasting everyone's time. Let's get down to business, because the reason we're all here, these awards, let's hand over now to Heidi. Heidi, give us a bit of background why we're having these awards and what they signify for all the people watching. Heidi, everybody.
Hello. It's always so heartwarming to give this award. And at the same time, you're always thinking that actually each one of our leaders, each teams, all our 150 countries, all our partners, they're giving their heart, they're giving their time of their life. Everybody deserves of this kind of awards. And actually, all these awards are for everybody. But there are always this kind of people who are somehow surprising you, or this kind of teams which is surprising you, or have been made a huge growth. So we like to show them the world, and also to recognize hard work from these leaders. So that's why we have this award ceremony to celebrate the big success of the Let's Do It World Network. Thank you.
Fantastic. So we have a number of categories that we're going to go through, and one by one we'll announce the winner. So Heidi, without further ado, as they say, do you want to go into the first category?
Yes. We are also... So the first is the biggest mobilizer of volunteers on the World Cleanup Day. And of course, I think we all do know that it is a fantastic and huge country who have been always made and being like a flagship in this World Cleanup Day in many 3 years already. And it's of course our Let's Do It Indonesia team have brought out many millions of people this time, 4.1 million people. And last year's it have been 7 million and more than 9 million. So it's a huge thank you for all the Let's Do It Indonesia team. And this team is really huge, the same huge as a country itself is with his population. And we congratulate Let's Do It Indonesia for this huge success. Thank you so much.
Indonesia, congratulations. Is there someone from Indonesia who would like to say a quick word? Unmute your microphone, tell us your name and how you're feeling after receiving that award. And I see people in the chat are congratulating Indonesia already. So if there is someone from the Indonesia team, before we move on to our next award. Yes.
Thank you so much for this award from Indonesia. And of course that so many Indonesian team also here tonight and to see, and they are so happy, of course, for this awardee. And as every year, we are really happy to be a part and to take a part of World Cleanup Day together with others country. And we hope that next year we can involve again, we hope we can bring 5% of population of our people in Indonesia to join the actions. So thank you for all the leaders and all the team partners and our government, and also for our miracles. That is our network from all around the world. Thank you so much.
Well done. Well done, Augustina. Well done, Indonesia, for putting in another huge effort. And for the last number of years, they have just been doing Trojan work. So a huge congratulations. Heidi, we'll hand back over to you for the next category.
Yes, the highest percentage of volunteers per capita at World Cleanup Day 2020. We had so many countries who have made really huge cleanups with so many participants. This country is really outstanding. It's our neighbor country who have made huge cleanups all the time, but not just the cleanups, but also planting the trees, working with the government, working on sustainable solutions, always have been part and next to their huge movement since 2009 already. And this is Liela Talka, which is actually Let's Do It Latvia.
Ooh, well done. Round of applause for Let's Do It in Latvia. Leila, are you there to say a quick hello?
Yes, this is organization name, but I hope maybe Vita is here or Iva is here or someone from a fantastic Latvian team. And
beautiful Latvia, right next door to you. They're your neighbors.
Estonia, yes.
Now, any of the Latvian team want to say hello to accept the award?
Anyhow, we are saying huge congratulations to Latvia team, and they have mobilized always like a 10% of their population, which is really big amount.
That is incredible. And another small country, isn't that right? Just beside you on the Baltic Sea.
2.5 million people, if I remember well.
Okay.
Estonia is 1.3. So yeah, it's a bigger.
Top marks in geography class, Heidi.
Yeah.
Okay, if we last call out to Latvia, if they're in the crowd, if you want to say a word on recipient of your award. Okay, Heidi, as the music comes in, we'll move on to you for the next category, the next award.
Yes, the engagement champion despite the COVID-19 at World Cleanup Day. Here we have more countries which have been made big cleanups and also working outstandingly with their partners. So our first organization is a national cleanup day, United States, working with Earth Day, with Keep America Beautiful, have made really huge cleanups and mobilizers last year, 1.7 million. This year, 560,000 people, and working so well with Let's Do It World. And also is a board member of the Let's Do It World. So huge congratulations to
Bill and Steve, National Cleanup Day in the USA. Bill and Steve, how are you two getting on?
Well, never mind.
No, I hate him. He hates me. It works really well.
No, you don't. You both love each other.
We're having a great time. We thank you all for the support around the world.
And thank you for this certificate of appreciation. That's very nice.
So I think there's only, because of cutbacks, you know, there's only one certificate. So who's going to put it up on their wall? Is it you, Bill, or Steve?
Bill.
Steve.
You'll be fighting over it. You know what? We might even get two out in the post to you. So thank you so much. Round of applause. Round of applause for Bill and Steve, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
The two funniest guys, I think, in the whole team. So thank you so much. Lots of love. And with that love, we hand it back over to Tallinn in Estonia, to Heidi.
Yes, and I'm shortly talking about the next team, which we are not showing yet. I just want to say that this team is remarkable in this way that it's a really big team working just since 2017. And in this year or last year, it has been tremendous, huge growth by partnerships. And they're working with so many partners, doing so great work with them. The reports that have been sent have been taking like a breath away. And we do see it's a really big flagship for all the Latin America to show the best example. And this is our organization, which name is World Cleanup Day Mexico.
Hey, congratulations, Mexico, the World Cleanup Day in Mexico, in the Americas. If someone is on the line from Mexico, say hello, and you can say a few words after receiving that beautiful certificate.
And this year they mobilized 560,000 people. And you know, it's always not a question about their numbers, but the way how much you put your heart into this activity. And we have been seeing that this passion what Roberto is putting with all the teams into this activity, and it's always so inspirational. So huge congratulations to all Latin America region, and there are so great leaders in Latin America. And
so many great leaders. And that's a good point you said, Heidi, as well, that it's not necessarily the largest numbers that are the winners or the ones that stand out. It's the ones with the most passion and who put their heart and soul into it.
And if Roberto or someone from Mexico is not here, yeah, it's quite early for them right now. Anyhow, I like to see or say also the next certificate is going to Asia, and it's one of the countries who have been growing so rapidly and also worked really hard for this year. And it was also really huge inspiration. And this country is Kazakh Eli from Kazakhstan.
Kazakhstan.
You are here, Shashalim, and the award is yours.
Thank you very much, Heidi, Colm. It's a really pleasure to receive such a award, especially this day, and it's really nice to have, and that you accept our strength and willing to make it our world a little bit cleaner and better. I don't know what to say. It's first time on a award like that. And really nice to get something.
You're speechless. Well, come here. What was the key? You put a lot of hard work into it to getting to this point. What do you think was the key to your success?
I think when you're doing something, you need to be open-hearted, and go without expecting something back. As it was old people say, if you do something good stuff, throw it to the sea. And somewhere it will come back to yourself, and you don't even understand from where it comes to you. But never try to get things back to you. So this, I think, is a success point for us, that we're doing it without expecting something back to us.
Wow, that is a great way of summing it up. Great way of putting it, doing something and not looking for anything in return, doing it for the simple act of doing it and, you know, trying to benefit the planet and the environment. Well, well done. Round of applause, everyone, once again for our friends there. Well done on that award. And now we'll head back to Tallinn in Estonia, to Heidi for the next one.
Yes, the next movement or organization have been really big surprise by numbers and by the organization itself. It's from Africa, and this organization is from Ethiopia, and it's UN Habitat Ethiopia. And they mobilized more than 800,000 people from Addis Ababa and all these big cities. I think they have like a 26 million people, if I'm correct, but I'm not sure. But anyhow, country is big, population is big, the mobilization was really big, and we were totally surprised that this kind of organization, which is our partner, of course, is mobilizing through across all the countries so much of people. And this is amazing. I'm not sure that UN Habitat people or someone is representing here, but big applause to this organization.
Yes, well done. They may not be on the line now, but they spoke so well during the conference. So to UN Habitat in Ethiopia, well done on your award and for mobilizing so many people to help out in this cause. And it's great to have partners like you. So thank you very much. Round of applause once again. This is a round of applause. See, people, when you put your hand around like this, it's a round of applause. And what's this? Vroom, vroom, vroom. That's an engine ear. You can use these jokes if you'd like. Heidi, back to you, and you can try and match those jokes if you'd like to.
Yes. And an organization from Europe, you know, in Europe, there are so many great leaders, and our network members have been in many years in Let's Do It world. And it's really hard to take just one and say that this is this organization. And my heart is bleeding because I want to say that everybody are so great. During these years, we have been seeing the growth and also working with different kind of partners and taking different kind of activities. And we'd like to say huge congratulations to our leader, the Mediterranean, have been part of the Let's Do It world, I think, since 2011. And it's Let's Do It Italy.
Hey, Let's Do It Italy. Congratulations, Italy. Well done. Do we have someone from Italy on the line?
Vincenzo, are you here? Or Alessandro? Vincenzo.
I see people saying congratulations to Italy in the chat now. Francesco has he has been on so many conferences over the past couple of days. Maybe he's taking a break and he's asleep in bed.
Or he is in a cleanups.
Or he's at a cleanup. Probably more likely, Heidi, you're right. So if no one is here from the Italy team, we will applaud them and we'll move on. And we'll go back to you, Heidi, for the next one.
Yes, the best partner in digital cleanup. Of course, you do know that we had a really a new baby in this last year, which is digital cleanup. And we also mobilized a partner. So our biggest partner in its international organization is Siemens Gamesa, who have been mobilized, the employees, in to take part of this digital cleanup. So thank you.
Well done. Thank you, Siemens. And I remember, Heidi, I think it was last year or the year before when we started doing the digital cleanup, and I thought, what is this all about? But then it made total sense when I watched the documentary about the servers around the world and the data centers and the amount of air conditioning they use and the amount of power that they consume is just incredible. It builds up to a couple of percent of the global power consumption. And all that, the space, every file attachment, every JPEG, anything we have stored anywhere needs to be on a server somewhere and cooled, and it's burning energy. So the less data we have on our devices, the less power consumption is needed somewhere in the world and the less fossil fuels burn. So it makes total sense. And thank you, Siemens, for partnering with us on that. So Heidi, we'll move on to the next one. So it's back over to you.
Yes, and the best partner mobilizing during Work Cleanup Day 2020. And this is a new partner for Let's Do It World. And it's something from what we are expecting a lot. The organization behind of all the continent, bringing well-known athletes of Africa together. And this organization is African Olympic Committee, consisting all the African national Olympic committees and mobilizing quite many countries with 1 month period, just signing the MOU in August and already mobilizing so many countries in Africa to be part of the Work Cleanup the last year. It was a very huge surprise. And now we are working further with different kind of programs. And we are looking very much from this cooperation, and this is really needed, especially for this region. Huge thank you for African Olympic Committee, to Monsef Demouchi and Honorable President, and big applause. I think Monsef is not here.
African Olympic Committee, and as Heidi has stressed before, for us to reach the goal that we want to reach, we need partners with that kind of scale and reach as well, right across the African continent. So thank you so much, and for speaking at the conference this year. Heidi, back to you.
Yes, and the coolest campaign for Work Cleanup Day. And you know, it's always, it's really hard also to pick up because, or to select what is there, this kind of coolest campaign, because we are so creative here in Let's Do It World, and there are a lot of many different really great campaigns. Not to mention how this cleanup have been made and so on. But this organization is coming from the biggest country in the world by population. They have been part of the Work Cleanup Day and Let's Do It World like four years. The heart is always there. They're working so hard. They are so great people. And this is Pick Up China with what presentation you saw also during the conference, and there are so phenomenal people there. So huge thank you, Pick Up China. I hope that Kai Kai or NU is here and can receive this really great certification of appreciation. Thank you.
Well done, China. And I think everyone will agree with you as well, Heidi, that the presentation was just incredible. And the efforts they went to get the message out there. Let's see if anyone from China is on the line, is watching, unmute your microphone, say hello now. I remember watching their presentation as well. They got electronic screens, billboards, cartoon characters, action figures and action heroes involved, pop stars, celebrities. It's incredible. China, are you in the house, China? Yes, I hear someone whispering. No, we don't. I think China, maybe the time difference, they're not here at the moment. But Heidi, congratulations once again to China. I see people in the comments are congratulating them. We'll hand back to you.
Yes. Then we'd like to also say thank you for all the biggest media engagers, and they have different kind of certificates and different kind of awards for that. And we also saw some of these presentations, and this is really great organization. Since 2017, it is a first a leader for me. It's from Europe who have been part of the Let's Do It World network to mobilize 5% of the people on their countries. They always have been done also really great campaigns, and they were hugely visible in this year as well. And we even had a feedback from United Nations SDG organization that said that, well, in Netherlands, everywhere is a Work Cleanup Day. So thank you, Plastic Soup Foundation from Netherlands. Robert, I saw you here already. You have to
be here. And Robert's ready to accept the award.
Thank you, Heidi.
Netherlands. And Robert, over to you. How do you feel in getting this certificate?
I'm proud. I never expected to win an award today, but I'm very pleased and honored that we are receiving this award. So thank you so much, Heidi, for all your work into this. And I'm a happy man. What can I say?
Robert, you've said it perfectly. You've summed it up really well. And let's just ask you one thing, because, you know, this conference, the Let's Do It World Conference, is all about us sharing our knowledge or ideas so we can learn from each other and all grow together. So what do you think? I'll ask you the same question. Was the key to your success?
I think primarily the working together with organizations like the government, of course, but also I think for us has been very important was working together with media partners. So we reach out to a lot of broadcasters in the Netherlands, big ones, and we ask them, could you provide free ad space to spread our word, our important message? And they did, and they wanted to help. So I think it's all about working together with those kind of organizations, which helped us a lot. And to get some prominent figures aligned, such as Frans Timmermans, the first vice president of the Euro Commission, I think that was also, that made it very, a next level, you know? So I think that combination was, I think, gold for us.
Robert, thank you very much. Round of applause for Robert, everyone in the Netherlands. So we move from the land of tulips and the windmills, Holland, and we go back to Estonia and to Haiti.
Thank you. Yes, thank you. So I'm really pleased to see and to say this name. It's really active organization, sort of like a not newcomer, but the leader is really, really active and all the team is really active. They are from Africa. And they are really great in making influence in media, especially in Facebook. And it was really, really visible. And we like to have the certificate and all this award and to say, thank you so much, Nangyok, and let's do it, Cameroon.
Oh, Cameroon. Round of applause for Cameroon, everyone. So enthusiastic over the conference as well. Do we have Cameroon on the line now? I know they haven't missed any of the talks. They've been in most of them, and we've been talking. Anyone from Let's Do It Cameroon? All the people of Virginia, Augustina are saying, congratulations, Cameroon. They really pushed the boundaries when it came to social media. I saw some of the posts as well, and they kept the ante up. They really did a great job. Heidi, we'll all round of applause for Cameroon, and we'll hand back to you in Tallinn, Estonia.
Thank you. Thank you. And the next certificate and award is for their best engager in Twitter, which is also coming to Africa. And this team and leader is absolutely phenomenal. I cannot speak enough about this great person. And working so well with Let's Do It World, and the heart is there for all the region, and she's so great. So, Christine Sayo and Let's Do It Kenya, thank you so much.
Christine, congratulations, round of applause for Let's Do It Kenya. I was talking to Christine the other day, lovely person. Again, her heart is in it, and that's very obvious when talking to her. Christine, are you on the line? And here's a video message recorded earlier from Christine. No, she's not. She's taking a break after all the cleanup, after all the talking and listening over the last couple of days. But congratulations on your award. And Heidi, we'll move on to the next one.
Yes. The next award is going to organization, which have been really long in Let's Do It World as well. And it's special and best social media influencer 2020 in Instagram. And this is going to another continent, which is in Latin America. And this is Vamos Hacerlo Argentina. Congratulations.
Congratulations, a round of applause for Argentina, beautiful Buenos Aires, the capital there in South America. And I don't think we have someone from Argentina on the line, but let's just check.
But we have Mauro Porcella here, I think, like the regional director for Latin America, also living in Buenos Aires. Mauro, are you here? I think John is not here, but maybe Mauro is here.
Mauro, if you're here, you'd like to say a few words on behalf of the team in Argentina. Please, the floor is all yours. I think, you know what, Heidi, people have started taking the bottles. I saw the minute Robert got his award, he nearly swallowed a full bottle of beer. So maybe people are a bit slower on the Zoom calls today. But Heidi, we'll hand back to you. I know we just have one or two more to go. I'm looking at the list here. And we're going to go on to the next one. This is a great one, actually, next.
And I saw Vincenzo here as well. He was really surprised already. Vincenzo, we are not coming back now to your certificate.
Vincenzo, Vincenzo, are you there?
Thank you very much.
Wait. How are you, Vincenzo? When we called out your award, what were you doing? Were you eating some gnocchi?
Now I have some problem with the connection, and now I enter inside.
Vincenzo, to you and the team in Italy, congratulations. I know you're there in beautiful Milan.
Thank you.
Enjoy it, have a glass of wine, and enjoy your Sunday night.
Thank you so much.
Heidi, back to Estonia.
Thank you. It was a great achievement in cooperation with the government. And this organization have been really long also in Let's Do It World since 2011, also from Africa. We heard the work about their ban of the single-use plastic with the government. And it's actually ended with legislations in this year. And we'd like to nominate and say our thank you for ANFRAS, which is Let's Do It Mauritius, for the hard work. And it's really great inspiration to all our leaders. And definitely we can learn from your best practices, which is really big idea of being a network. I don't know, is Raj here or Chris Appadu? I think I saw Chris. And please receive with this huge respect this award and this certification on behalf of Let's Do It World.
Thank you, Heidi. Thank you, Let's Do It World. Really appreciate it. I didn't expect that at all. I'm deeply honored and deeply touched as well. Thank you.
Mauritius, such a lot of work done in Mauritius and incredible turnout, incredible results. I'll ask you the same question I've asked the others. Again, what do you think was the key to you getting it right and your success?
We've been engaging all the NGOs, all the club service in Mauritius as well. And we appointed regional ambassadors in the different regions of Mauritius. Mauritius is small and we have 9 districts. So we appointed 9 ambassadors to work closely with the local council. And it went very well last year, where we achieved like plus 49% of participants than previous year. And we've seen the number of group registered increasing significantly.
Chris, thank you so much. And congratulations once again to you and all the team in Mauritius. A round of applause for them as we head back to Heidi for the final award, I think, of the night.
We have also most impactful photos during the World Cleanup Day, and we have been used them a lot. And we want to say huge thank you to Let's Do It Ghana.
Ghana.
Kato Boko, I don't know, are you here? But their photos, what you have made, are fantastic. And we used it quite a lot in our annual report and also in all the presentations, talking and sharing the knowledge about the Let's Do It World Cleanup Day. Thank you so much. Let's Do It Ghana.
Do we have Ghana in the house? Would like to say a few words?
Thank you so much. Thank you. Not really. Thank you.
You're doing some important parenting duty as well. Is that right?
Yes. Yes.
Who's there with you?
Thank you so much. I'm grateful. Thank you. Ghana is grateful. Thank you.
Thank you. Wait,
listen, can I just ask you very quickly about the beautiful photographs that you took that were so powerful and impactful? Was it a deliberate decision? Did you go after a certain style, or was it just you're just very good at taking photographs?
We were trying to, we're taking photographs because we need evidence of things we do. You need to show it. And by people seeing what you do, it's going to motivate them. So we made a conscious effort to document everything we're doing. Yeah.
Well, Kate, very quickly, why don't you turn on your camera so we can say hello and congratulations on the award.
Okay.
I was going to say sorry for putting you on the spot, but I'm not really sorry. Let's see, beautiful Kate there. I know you're busy at the moment.
Okay.
Okay.
There she is.
Yeah, sorry, in the kitchen. Just cooking.
That's great.
Cooking up a storm, Kate.
Yes.
Congratulations. That is fantastic. I think that is any of our action set.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm looking forward to dinner. I'll be over in an hour for dinner. It smells good, whatever you're cooking there. Heidi.
I'll be expecting you.
Okay. I've been keeping my appetite all day. Heidi, that concludes the awards. And again, I mean, you've said it yourself. If we could give awards to everyone, we would, because...
Yeah, I'm doing it. And yes. There is another country who was exceptional with the photos and have been always exceptional with the photos. We can see it absolutely everywhere. And this is so far have been the biggest mobilizer in Africa. This year have been really hard on them because of the COVID. Still, they are working with Ministry of Environment, with a lot of ministries, mobilized a lot of schools, working with the mayor, working with eco clubs, green clubs, and this is fantastic work what they are doing. Our really big heart of passion in our network, and this is Carlos Serra, Let's Do It Mozambique. Congratulations for you too, for absolutely great photos, always what you're providing to this Let's Do It world. Thank you, Carlos.
Thank you very much. I'm here. Thanks. Yeah.
What's your trick? What's the photography trick that you use to get such beautiful images?
Difficult to say.
It comes naturally, Carlos. But what does it mean to you, the certificate and being involved in the Let's Do It movement?
Yeah. It's difficult to say. I'm going to the airport at this moment. I was not prepared to talk at this moment. I don't know.
Carlos, anywhere nice?
Follow my heart, just that.
Great. Hey.
I love our children. Do you know the children are the future? That's it.
Yeah.
They say me what to do, and I do.
Beautiful. Carlos, thank you so much. If you're flying somewhere, safe trip, and maybe if you're picking up someone, a loved one, will then have a safe journey as well there to the airport. And we'll hand back to Heidi now. For the rest of the awards, I just spotted on my screen on the next slide.
Yes, thank you. Is our best mapper during the World Cleanup Day. And this is an organization who have been... in part of the Let's Do It World family also since 2009 or 2010, so forever. And really great engager of our info technology and this kind of knowledge, providing always support and help. And this is Ionut Iordachescu, Let's Do It Romania. Thank you so much, Ionut, for all the help and being also best mapper for this year.
Congratulations. Let's Do It Romania. And if someone from Romania is on the line, say hello so you can accept your award. I think I hear some noise there.
I saw you not here.
Let's do it, Romania. Are you there? Maybe we'll come back to them if they come on like we did with Italy. Let's do it, Italy. But Heidi, we'll go back to you for the next award.
Yes, the best waste mapping manager. The best mapping manager is coming from Uprachme Slovensko. Thank you so much for your contribution for being a best mapping manager. I hope that here is someone from this team. And if not, Lucia, maybe you, I saw Lucia here. Lucia, maybe you want to say something about this great organizations. Lucia is our partner organization who is working with, we are working with mapping. Lucia?
Yeah, thank you, thank you. I think I'm the only one from the team here. So I'm responsible for both threshold application and I'm part of the Upravo Slovensko that is doing cleanups. And I'm glad that this year we managed to do the mapping campaign because we were not able to do that much of a group cleanup. So we sort of like used the mapping campaign as an engagement because we were not able to do physical that much. So so yeah, thank you for the appreciation.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for that great work.
Round of applause. Congratulations. And Heidi, we'll move on to the next one.
Yes. You know, when you are mapping, it's really important also to clean up the spots. And it always have been a really big discussion that we have to do it, right? So we have also the best cleaner, cleaner after the waste mapping. And certificate, and this time it's a really huge organization, really have been really long also in our organization, with really huge cleanups, with really passionate leader, and this is, let's do it, Ukraine, Yulia.
Ukraine, Yulia, our favorite. I'm not even going to say, Yulia, are you there, because I know Yulia would never miss this. So Yulia, how are you feeling?
Hello, everyone. Thank
there
you, Heidi. Thank you all around the world. Thank you, our team, our partners, because it's happened now, because we have many, many people, good people, special enthusiastic volunteers in my country. But I think next this year will be more. So let's do it. Thank you so much, everyone.
Yulia, a round of applause. And Yulia's dedication is just incredible, because it was yesterday, the day before, when she was speaking at one of the sessions in the conference. She had just come off, was it a flight, like a few hours before that? Wasn't that right, Yulia?
Yeah.
Thank you for confirming that.
But today I'm here with you. So, and thank you very much, Colm, because you motivate us to every year.
Yulia, thank you so much. And congratulations on all your work on social media everywhere behind the scenes. The Instagram queen of Let's Do It World. Now, let's hand back to Heidi.
Yes, as you know, we also run the cigarette butts campaign, and it was highly successful in those countries who made this campaign. And some of the stories are something which is really going into the heart immediately when you are hearing them. This team have been also part of Let's Do It World so long, working in really hard conditions, always supporting, always proactive. It's amazing leadership by Nima Zare, Let's Do It Iran. Thank you so much, Nima.
Nima in Iran. Congratulations.
Thank you
and
so much.
And as well, again, you gave a great talk during the conference. Are you there?
Yeah. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much. Thank you, team. Thank you, Heidi. You know, I am so grateful for having this chance to be a part of this great family, wonderful family. And your support means a lot to me. Thank you so much. Thank you, my friends.
Nima, thank you so much. And thank you for being part of the family, part of the team.
Thank you so much.
And Floor is mine again. We also are conducting their brand audits, and we cannot say the best conductors of the brand audit. We simply are part of the brand audit. And this year, we had six countries who participated in brand audits. Not so much. It has been a really big one in last year's. But I hope that with Break Free from Plastic, which is our partner in this year, we are doing it in a much, much visible way. Last year was really hard for the pandemic situation. But here we want to say thank you to Let's Do It Ghana.
Ghana, once again, congratulations.
Thank you.
Ghana, you're cooking dinner and you're winning awards left, right, and center.
Yes. It seems I'm going to celebrate tonight, so eat something good to eat.
And the next award for the Master Chef, the best cooking, goes to Kate in Ghana.
And the next award my team is so grateful.
Goes to Kate in Ghana. Congratulations. Heidi, back to you.
Thank you.
And the next country who have been conducted their brand audits is basically next. And this is Let's Do It Benin. I'm not sure Fatah is here, but congratulations for this initiative. We're really long also in our Let's Do It World Network, conducting really great cleanups, doing really hard work. Thank you, Let's Do It Benin.
Let's Do It Benin. Round of applause. Is anyone from the team on the line? I think not. So we will go back to you now, Heidi, and on to our next award.
Next award is going to neighbor country, which is Let's Do It Togo. Thank you, Let's Do It Togo.
Thank you, Let's Do It Togo. Anyone from the Togo team on the line, you want to say a few words?
Yes, thank you, Edi.
Oh, Noel.
Yes, Edi. I'm so grateful for this. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Noel, just while we have you there and you're receiving this award, as I've been asking some of the other recipients, what do you think really made it such a success for you? If you wanted to share one pearl of wisdom with the rest of the team.
Is though to put our heart in what we are doing. What we love is, and the one thing we have is our unique planet. So we have to take care every day.
Well said, nice and simple. Noel, thank you so much. And congratulations as well, and to you and everyone who took part there and the whole team. Heidi, I'll hand back to you.
Yes. And the next brand audit certificate is also going to Africa. And once again, congratulations, Let's Do It Kenya.
Kenya, congratulations, the whole team, and Let's Do It Kenya on your certificate. If we have someone from the Kenya team on the line, we can say a quick hello and congratulate you.
I think Christine is not here.
Christine, who we called on before, yes, but we will present it to them afterwards. And Heidi, in the meantime, we'll hand back to you and Talon and Estonia.
Yes. And we also want to say huge thank you for the brand audits to Vamos Haslero Colombia. And Mauro is not, I think, here, but this organization have been really long also in Let's Do It World Network, and also made just recently really big cleanups and have been developed the corporations with different kind of partners. So it's really great initiatives, and we are really happy to have this kind of huge country on board of Let's Do It World. Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Colombia. Well done. Congratulations on another certificate. So Heidi, we will keep on moving on to the next one.
Yes, and then a certificate going to Nipefagio, Tanzania. I don't know Anna is here or not yet, but also doing fantastic cleanups, fantastic zero waste, activities, working also with schools. Congratulations, Nipe Fakio.
An applause, Nipe, in Tanzania. Are you on the line? I know some people scramble sometimes to get the unmute button, so we give them a moment.
I also want to say that all these certifications are also sent by the Break Free from Plastic, so we can send you both of these certifications operations from Let's Do It World, but also from Break Free from Plastic.
Perfect, fantastic. We'll move on to the next one. And I see people in the comments are saying congratulations. Over 100 people watching saying congratulations and sharing the joy online as well, I see in social media, which is great to see.
And the best international cooperation with Let's Do It World Network, of course, it's not a surprise because you all see in visible way what is happening. We conducted really huge conference with really great cooperation between three teams. And this certificate is going to all the team who have worked for the conference and takes this responsibility to lead this conference. So Holger Holland and Let's Do It Germany, huge applause and our gratitude.
Huge applause for Holger in Germany, the whole team, Let's Do It Germany, Let's Do It Indonesia as well.
And of course, not just Let's Do It Germany, but also Let's Do It Indonesia.
Indonesia as well. But let's start, Holger, are you there? Of course you're there. Holger's on every session, every Zoom session. He hasn't slept in 5.5 months. Holger, how are you?
Exhausted, yes, but really, really happy. Thanks for this award, yes. That's really cool, really, really great, yes. Okay, thank you.
And, Holger, how are you feeling? You know, it was such a challenge to do this because it's new to us. It's new to everyone in the world to have a conference like this digitally, to have it virtually. So as we come to the close of the conference and we soon will be extinguishing the candle, the conference candle, how are you feeling at the moment?
Can you please ask me next week? Yes, really, really happy. It's incredible, yes. And it shows how strong our network is and what is possible if we do it together. And in this case, between Europe and Asia and make this conference possible. In a time, it's a weird time, yes, we're living really, the pandemic is really hard for. You see my wording is going away, yes, because I'm really exhausted, and also really happy that the last days, that everything goes on this way, and this cooperation was such a success, it's incredible. So, yes, I and my team are really happy.
Holger, congratulations and well done. Another round of applause for everyone in Let's Do It Germany for hosting such a great conference this year. Really brilliant. And just everything went so smoothly. And they couldn't have done it on their own. A lot of support, particularly from Let's Do It Indonesia, as Heidi mentioned, who are a recipient of this award too. So, Augustina, Let's Do It Indonesia, how important was this for you as well to be involved to make sure this all worked, even though we were doing it virtually this year?
Yes, come. Sorry, can you hear me?
I can hear you perfectly.
Yeah, suddenly my internet connection is not really clear. Yeah, we are so happy to be part of this conference, working together closely with Let's Do It Germany. And sad to say that tonight, that's it's the last day for our conference. Already late in Indonesia, it's already night, but. It's also happy that we now move forward to the next step. Then after that, we will host the conference next year in Indonesia, working together also with Let's Do It Germany and support with the HK team from Estonia. So yeah, I could say that it's such an honor to work with this great team. Let's Do It Germany team is really amazing team. Thank you.
What a great synergy. If anyone knows Augustina, her power, her passion, her commitment, and Germany have that too. So when you put them together, it's like an atomic bomb, but the good type of atomic bomb, like with lots of energy and love and everything going so smoothly. So thank you so much, Augustina. And Augustina said she's disappointed it's finishing up tonight, but the good news is we're extending the conference for a whole week. I'm only joking. Holger had a heart attack there. Don't worry, Holger, you're safe. Heidi, we'll go back to you for the... Holger fell off his seat nearly. Heidi, back to you in Tallinn, Estonia.
Yeah, thank you. the next award is about the most proactive leader in Let's Do It World Network. And, you know, as Holger said, that we are cooperating so well as a global movement and global network. And this is absolutely true. And it's really hard to find the most proactive leader because we have so many of them. And I'd like to name, like, 50, 100 of them. But we name here once again our respective leader from Let's Do It Kenya, and it's Christine Sayo. She has already 3 certificates. Thank you so much, Christine.
Kenya, well done, Iran. Again, you're building up the certificates. You're going to have them all over the wall, like wallpaper everywhere. Beautiful to look at, but well deserved. I mean, these are given out for a very good reason. So congratulations.
Thank you. And we have another leader as well who is really proactive, always there, always responding as really you're asking. He is always there. He is always there. And also providing an ideas or started this kind of a new development in Let's Do It World. And it really was something what we are looking as a global organization to have this kind of feedbacks and ideas from our leaders. And this is again, Nima Zara, Let's Do It World. I'm sorry, Let's Do It Iran. Thank you so much.
Nima and Iran, a round of applause. How are you feeling now? I know we called you a moment ago.
Sorry, I have a poor connection and I can't hear you clearly.
Don't worry, Nima. We are just telling you how brilliant you are and how well the team did in Iran. So we're paying you lots of compliments.
Thank you, Heidi. Thank you, the team. Thank you, Holger. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
We'll go back to you. I think this is now the final award of the night. The next one.
As the next one, is a final. It's a final, and this is an ambassador of values of Let's Do It World Network, which is really crucial because we are holding our values when we are serving this really great aim. What we are doing here, we're putting our heart there. We are working days and nights. We are putting all our resources, which is mostly time. Even if you have home, family, or little babies, you still are here and working because we believing in the cause what we are doing. We're always supporting each other. And this leader is really remarkable because he has always this, a little baby, other work, and he always there. He's never missing anything. He is translating in one language to another language, mobilizing, thinking strategically. And this is really huge appreciation to the person who is not unfortunately here right now, but I hope that he can see it later on. It will be a huge surprise to him. And I really hope that he will be the same motivated and the same driven to their goal. And this is Mauro Borsella, the director of the Latin region in Let's Do It World, a board member of Let's Do It World. And huge thank you for being who you are. Thank you.
Beautiful. A great compliment to get. Thank you for being who you are. So Mauro, I know you're not here with us at the moment, but we will get that certificate to you later on. And as Heidi said, we're sure you'll be shocked, but well-deserved as well. So that concludes this part of the award show, giving out the awards to all the very deserving participants all over the world, to those who are here in the hundreds who are watching, or to those who will get the news later on, because we're conscious as well that we're a global team. So in many parts of the world now, it's the middle of the night. It's very early in the morning, whatever time it could be. But now, Heidi, we're going to talk about next year. Always looking ahead, always looking forward, and to the next host. I know Augustina let the cat out of the bag a small bit. She gave a clue, but give us the news, Augustina and Heidi.
Augustina, which one?
Heidi start first, or I will turn off my video because it just didn't work well here. Sorry, because of my connection. Will you go first, Heidi, or me go first?
Please take this honor and go first. Please.
Augustina, you can go first.
Thank you so much. So for the next conference in 2022 that Indonesia will become the host. So we are working together with Let's Do It Germany and of course HQ team as always working hard as well. And we are start preparing from next month, basically exactly after this conference. And we are preparing to have the conference offline. We still hope we can do it. But if even we if that is not possible, then we will have it online. So we hope that, however, we hope everyone will come together to Indonesia from more than 150 countries, and we are gathered in Indonesia in the next January 2022. If not, then we will gather again online. So thank you so much.
Augustina, knowing your passion and your drive, I've got a feeling we're all going to meet there in person. It will be an offline conference. If you have anything to do about it, it will be an offline conference. So Augustina, that is exciting. And Heidi, this is exciting for the whole team, isn't it? To be to having Indonesia, who, as you have been saying before, is such a big player, have been such an important part of the family, for them to host it next year, it's going to be very exciting.
Absolutely, absolutely. And we are really happy to work together, and we sort of like learn now first time how to do this kind of online conference. And of course, it's always so great to go into this kind of family meeting and to meet the people, you know, all together. And we have so much of this kind of regional WhatsApp groups as well. And I can see that the people are saying, or in Facebook, that, and it's so shame that we cannot be together, and we need to see each other and to share the best energies. And this is who we are. And the energy always is really present in this conference. So I'm really hoping, so next one, I hope this situation of the pandemic is going and we can go to their normal life. But if it will be online, it will be online.
Okay, and now Heidi, I know you're going to mute your microphone on that laptop there, because we're about to have our closing part of the ceremony, just as we began on Thursday when we kicked off the Let's Do It World Conference. This beautiful symbol that we've done over the past couple of years, the lighting of the candle representing the light of hope, the energy, the work that we all put into this, and it burns, it flickers for the entire couple of days over the duration of the conference. And now until next year, when we meet again in Indonesia, the candle is going to be extinguished. I know they're just setting up another camera, and we're going to see Heidi in a moment, who will say concluding words. But before Heidi says her concluding words, because I'll give her the final words as she deserves, I just want to say thank you so much for letting me host this conference again. It's a pleasure and an honor for me to be part of the family. And until we talk again on World Cleanup Day or next year, I hope that you and your family and your loved ones are safe from the pandemic, and you have a wonderful 2021. It's been an absolute pleasure. And Heidi, we'll hand over to you now for the final words and the extinguishing of the candle.
Yes, and before I'm going ending up this candle, I want to say a huge thank you for all the teams who have participated in this Let's Do It World conference, all the guests and partners who have been participating in it, all our leaders who share the stories, and a really huge thank you for Let's Do It Germany, Holger, Philipp, Sonia, Stephanie, many people in Let's Do It Germany. And a huge thank you to Augustina Iskandar, Andy, and many people from Let's Do It Indonesia. And I want to say really huge thank you to Let's Do It World CEO, Anneli Offrill. And I hope that she can turn the camera or come here. This is Anneli, who has been huge applause to her. Well, she has been absolutely phenomenal person to holding the teams together. Come here, Anneli. We are doing it together, not just Heidi here. It's always Anneli too. And I want to say a huge thank you to Ingrid Nielsen from headquarters, to Raimo Onos, who is holding this
to Farishtamo, to Merrick. So many people, and I'm sorry if I didn't say anyone name. And Mart, of course, really important person, let's do it Estonia. So there are a lot of people. And if I don't say your name, you know that we are very grateful for you, everything that you have done here. Unfortunately, we have to end our conference. It has been a huge pleasure to share this space in the world with you. And we are so thankful that you are trusting us, and we are all together as a huge family, and we are going to the next activities and to the next World Cleanup Day and to the next conference. Let this light will be lighting our path and way to the fantastic and great things that we are doing to the world. Please keep your hearts, and let's be really great humans. Thank you so much.
Okay. Congratulations. Yeah. Round of applause, everybody. Well done. Thank you so much, Annalie. Thank you so much, Heidi. And thank you so much, everyone around the world, for watching, for participating over the last couple of days. We are going to wave goodbye to Annalie and Heidi there in Tallinn, Estonia.
Hi.
Bye, they're saying. Annalie, thank you for all your hard work, team. And to everyone around the world watching this now, all the leaders from all the countries. And one thing that people mentioned over the last couple of days is that you're all champions. So to play us out, we are the champions. Thank you very much, everyone. Goodbye. God bless.
Colm, can I just say something?